during that time was around 1979, if I remember, I knew a friend, and we were aware of the need of surplus food that would be, what was it called, to be used. He was familiar with the structure of a food bank. He was always, that was his sense. So because we chatted like that, he says, well, perhaps we will invite a person from the Arizona Food Bank, who was happening, his name was Bob McCarty, to come and give us a workshop, as they call it, around the concept of a food bank and how it can be initiated and things like that. And so we did have a meeting eventually here with Bob McCarty. And so that's how it got started. And then the formalization of a food bank got started in 1981.
It's generally described that the first modern food bank in Canada is the Edmonton Food Bank. Again, not that Edmonton is the first place that would feed those who are hungry in the inner city, but to use a food bank model that comes out of the States. Yeah, so that's all part of it.
I worked with the people who were, what would you call, in need. I was becoming more aware of that. This we have to share our bread with the hungry, you know, and it was there within me.
Another strong sense from the very beginning is the sense of the gleaning. In a society like ours, so much of the food goes to waste. So it was a way to gather the surplus and to make it available for those who are hungry. And the gleaning is such a powerful symbol. So when you look at the food bank literature even today, you will see the famous picture of the gleaners in the field, the widows doing the second picking.
One of our staff, his name was John Hunkins, happened to be working in a place that he was working in a food bank that was in Phoenix, Arizona. And he shared with me, we talked about it, and the possibility that maybe this could also be introduced to Edmonton, the food bank concept.
It's incredible, obviously, how it's grown. In a very small rented space, right? No staff. In Capilano neighborhood, right? Not even the neighborhood, because the space was available to store some food. So then it grows, right? Goes to the armory, goes to a closed Safeway store in Boyle Street. So the growth of it.
And I said, the spirit of the food bank is one of love. Through the gathering of food and sharing it with the hungry, it can transform the community it serves.
Why does a city like Edmonton need such a large, you know, incredible organization like the Edmonton Food Bank? Why, what is there about our society that we're unable to have people support themselves that way, right? That poverty is such a continuing issue. And we see that today in the pandemic. And to really make a difference in people's lives at a very basic level around food. And then through that, begin to do a wider reflection around poverty, sharing, and serving.
I read the food bank newsletter that comes out. You know, I read the spirit behind that. And I am amazed about how people are responding to it. From their own little people, I want to help. I want to help. And as long as that spirit, I want to help, that's it.